A love to make today a cake, a snooker table or billiard table, depend on which country you live. It just has different a little bit variation of names, but everyone knows snooker table, so I will probably use this name. And what basically we need for that is for a main cake, we need a rectangular baking tin. If you have just a small party for your father or for the your friends, or just a not too big party, so you probably will use about 16 by 26, one of those smaller rectangular tins. But if you have larger party to serve, just take simply much larger rectangular tin and use two boxes of cake mix or your favorite cake recipe. What I doing is we have a 16 by 26. This is just enough for one box. And the reason is I have another baking tin here. It does not matter is it rectangular or round. We only need that to make our snooker balls basically, because we won't make them from cake. So does not matter would you use devil's food cake mix or chocolate cake mix or any cake mixes or your favorite recipe. It doesn't matter. See, what we need is basically I use two boxes because one goes for the snooker table itself, as you can see it's done, and second one is we bake it right here. We will use to make the snooker balls. I saw it depends how many snooker balls you want to place it. If you want not too many, as you can see, we already level our cake once we mix it and baking according to instruction on the box you're using or your recipe. Once it's baked and cooled down, level top to make sure it's nice and flat and place on your cake board. But 3 minutes from your cake, that's what how much would be here. It's probably would be even enough. It just depends how many snooker balls you're going to make it. I just for precaution bake another one to just make sure we have enough. So basically we're using one box for the rectangular baking tin to make an actual snooker table, and second one we use to make a cake to using snooker balls. So once we've done all that, as I said before, we level our cake and it's now flat on line on our cake board. So next is we just let it set aside because we don't need it right now. Next is we basically have a plate, which is we place non-stick baking paper on top, or just using this type of plate, doesn't really matter which is you're going to use. And on this plate we will place our snooker balls. We will not make them big, we will make them probably of a larger marble. So and use the chocolate frosting to just bonding cake basically our cake together, as well as a frosting you can use instead melted white or milk or dark chocolate, just enough to make sure your basically cake or your mixture is bonded into a ball and stay in a shape. So next step is we just take a little bit of our cake. I don't think we need a huge amount, and what we do is we just crumble up all together. It's be probably plenty snooker balls from this recipe. You what you can do, I saw with leftover cake, Just to put it in a clean wrap or food wrap, and place it in the freezer and use it for next time when you have your next recipe to make, when you have next cake balls to make, because do not throw it. It's actually very good cake, and in the freezer it stay for quite a long time. So next time you're going to make it cake balls or addition to your cake, what you do is simply take it out and just stir it in. You can actually make them right in. They actually even easier to make them from freezer. So once we crumble up all our mixtures, you can see it's nice and crumble. We just add kind of frosting, not too much, to make sure we try to bond our mixture together. So if it's not enough and it still fall apart, just add a little bit more frosting, or sometimes you can use cream cheese as well, but it just depends which kind of cake you're actually making. So once you added enough frosting, how you will know that you add enough frosting? Take small amount, because we're not making big really balls, because you don't want it that snooker balls overwhelm actual table, so they have to blend in and have the right look on it and the proportion. So as you can see, when we take small amount of the cake, it bonds very well together, and when you hold it, it's hold shape. So that's what you wanted. Once you make it little ball, just roll it to make it nice round shape, because you want make them even. And as you can see, it's actually quite small. It's like large marble. And make them as many as you like to place on a cake. I will make 15 red, 1 white, eventually it will be, and a few maybe different colors to scatter sort of around the snooker table. So, what we do is now, we place our prepared cake balls into freezer for just about 10 minutes, until we prepare our frosting. So, let's place in the freezer right now, and we prepare our frosting. Now it's interesting basically step when we will color our snooker balls. Today I like to make something a little bit different, which is I find it a little bit easier to decorate in one of those difficult cakes. So a snooker table is not a difficult cake, because we make it very, very easy. So once our cake balls come out from freezer, they're nice and firm. They don't have to be stay for a very long time, to just to set, sort of, that's enough. So next is, we're using vanilla frosting. Doesn't matter which vanilla frosting, would it be Betty Crocker, or I have Duncan Hines, any other brand will do. Just a classic vanilla frosting. So, to decorate various balls, we need different colors. You choose which, how many snooker balls you like to place it on the cake, as well as how many actually colors you like to make it too. So, I have some royal blue, green, black, red, and yellow. So, and white. One white ball, which is does not need any coloring, it just going straight like that. So key is to decorating this kind of balls is we just place one of those baking trays underneath and cooling rack on top, because we want just excess of frosting to drip down. So next step is, according to whatever color snooker ball you're making, say for example you're making black, so take a little bit of the vanilla frosting, place it in your saucepan, and add black gel food coloring to basically until you tint it to right proportion. You don't need hugely much because you only need one bowl. So you only need about 1 tablespoon of vanilla frosting to basically pour on top of your cake bowl. So with something with yellow, green, you just take about 1 heaped sort of tablespoon of vanilla frosting, add enough gel food coloring to make right color of your snooker bowl. And this is next interesting key. We have to place our the tinted vanilla frosting on top of our burner, on top of our stove, and to make sure it start practically boiling. Once it start boiling, it just start to basically piping, kind of like a sort of to boiling point, put this way. And once it get to this point, what we do is it's really pourable, so we pour on top of our bowls. Step have to be quite quick because it set really quick. So let's place our, which is we will tin now red color snooker bowls. As you can see, I place vanilla frosting firstly in my saucepan, then I add red gel food coloring, just enough to make it's red, and now we will place on top of our stove to boiling point. Then we can pour on top of our rest of snooker bowls. So now, as you can see, it started just a second ago, was boiling, and as you can see, it's become very, very pourable. So what we do, we just pour on our try to aim it. Pour, or just probably we can even use a spoon as well. See how we're going. As you can see, rest of the frosting drips down, and you can use also a spoon, of course, as well. Depends what sort of saucepan you're using. It's really, really quick process, and if it's a little bit start thickening, place again on the top of stove to thicken. If it starts thickening, place on top of stove to again get to boiling point. So what we do is next, we just let these bowls to completely set. They will harden, but not to a point that it's like rock or something. I saw another alternative probably. If you like it, you can use the different candy melts, melt it and place it just to the harden as well. You probably have to use something like a fork or skewers to lift them up. So as you can see, now they nicely done. So we let them set. This is other bowls who was done. As you can see, they already set and nicely. So that's what we want. So let's them set, and we start frosting our cake. By the time when our snooker bowls is sitting a little bit harder, so what we do is we take our cake and we frosting with the chocolate frosting. It depends what sort of cake you're actually using. It doesn't matter, vanilla frosting, chocolate frosting, buttercream, anything of your choice. So, and we have here green fondant, which is in a size bigger than your cake. If you don't have green fondant, use a white fondant and just simply tint it with a green gel food coloring like Americola or the Wilton. Once you roll it in a size bigger than your cake, what we do is next, we just simply transfer it on top. So we start working from top, make it nice and smooth, go through edges as well. It depends how warm in your kitchen. If it's already probably too warm, your fondant might be a little bit stick to your hand. So apply very small amount of powdered sugar to prevent sticking, but not too much, because you don't want to spoil green color of the cake. So working through the edges as well. And what we do is, once we're happy everything what we achieve, we just remove fondant, and it's just too excess, we don't need that. Bring up much closer to the cake. Do not using your fingernails, because you can make little sort of can pierce your cake. So just with your palm of your hand. And what we do is, here we just remove with our sharp knife, or if you have special equipment, sort of, we just remove excess of the fondant and just finish shaping. Once snooker balls basically sets, there will be a little bit sticky still, tiny bit. So what we do is, trick is to basically use a toothpicks to transfer them into position you really wanted. So basically we just place 15 red balls in right side and the white one as a in the front, and so you can place as many as you wanted and scatter sort of them around. Now to make the little numbers, you can use some sort of like a chocolate type of chip like that, place it on top if you like to do so, or take small piece of fondant, make it ball and just flatten it, will be exactly something. It just depends what you have available in your country. So once you flatten white fondant, so you can use black writing icing, or you can use food edible decorating pan, which is, it's good to eat, and basically place it on top. But firstly, we as you can see, I take my toothpicks, put it just down on the side, carefully transfer into position. And what you do is, don't pull toothpick, just tiny bit screw them, they will come out nice and clean. So next is place our prepared little number right on top. So we just nicely secure. And as you can see now, this is our very, very simple snooker table cake. Also, if you like to add some details, also you can actually use the brown fondant or the brown gel food coloring, and actually color sides as well if you like to do so. It's all up to you, basically. And I hope you do like this simple creation of the snooker table, basically it's great if you really try to. Thank you very much for your time with me today. Everything will be in the description box. Until next time, goodbye.